Hey guys, it is Liberty here from Spirit Move Ministries, and it is so awesome to be on with you. We are back in AZ from our California Prayer Summit. It was amazing to hang out with all of you this weekend in Ventura and just rock it for Jesus on the beach and just intercede for California and for the state. As you can see, I have my Ventura, California Premium California shirt on. Amen. I'm sporting it today just for you California peeps. Reminders of things coming up very quickly. Dallas is going to be at the end of April, so be watching for the info for that. There's also other things brewing. As you know, we will still be coming to Michigan over the summer, so be watching for information on Michigan. The Lord has recently spoke to me another location. I'm not ready to announce that yet. I need to get some more confirmations from the Holy Spirit of another state that we will be going to over the summer. And so just be watching for that. Also, be watching for all the fasts we're doing. We fast a full 7 days each month in preparation just for all that God is doing. So just be watching for that info as it comes out. We post it everywhere. And if you're not a part of the email list, go to spiritmove.store and you can add yourself to the email list. And that way you get all of our updates and that kind of stuff. I know some of you have said you don't get them. I recommend you check your promotions or you check your spam, because I tested it by signing myself up and it comes to my promotions. It doesn't come to my regular inbox. So sometimes, and plus when you're sending out thousands and thousands and thousands at a time, which is what we do, some might slip through the cracks. So just if you're not getting them and they're not coming to any of your inboxes, I recommend you go back and re-sign up for the emails. Also, Adventures in the Spirit. I was asked, I don't even know how long ago, 6 or 8 weeks ago, to be a guest on Adventures in the Spirit. It is a basically radio show podcast through Charisma, and they interviewed me, and I did two shows basically with them. And you can go to Adventures in the Spirit and hear the part one of the making of a Times and Seasons Prophet. That's kind of what we talked about. And then they're going to be doing part two, I believe tomorrow or the next day will come out. So be watching for those. But Adventures in the Spirit, you can go, you can find that on Spotify. You can find it through Google Play. You can find it through iTunes, CPN. You can go to the Charisma website and find it. However you have to do it, but you can find that. There's lots of different ways to find it. And so I would love for you to go, and you're going to be able to hear more of my story, because I was able to, you know, it's an interview, so I'm talking longer than I would on a video here with you. So I would love for you to go listen to the story of kind of how I became who I am today. So, but we are so excited for everything that God's doing, and God gave me an amazing word for California. Even if you don't live in California, don't tune this out. Don't not watch this word. This is a prophecy over California that God gave me over the weekend at the prayer summit, and I released it to California. Now, just so you understand, usually how it works is when I go to do a miracle healing service or a prayer summit, if God gives me a fresh word, I release it there first before I release it on YouTube, because I want them to be the first to hear it, are those that faithfully come and attend an event that we do. When they sacrifice to come, I want them to receive the fresh word first. And then I'll get on YouTube and, you know, release the word to everyone that was not able to make it. And so, or couldn't be a part of it, or you live too far away, or whatever it is. But this is a prophecy over California. And so the Lord basically spoke to me and said, there are glory waves. Many glory waves in California. There are waves of my glory. And he said, California is known for being on the ocean and having a lot of ocean, but he said it's much more than that. He said, there are many glory waves. There is plenty of glory in California. And he said, many in California have questioned this. They have questioned the ability to save California. What's God going to do? And the Lord said, the glory is there. Step into it, church. Step into it, body of Christ. And so this is a prophecy over California. Revival is coming to California. I have talked about this a little bit before, and I released this word over the weekend. And I have mentioned before that there's just things that are going to go down in California, but it's going to be for His glory. Now, so you understand, when God gave me this prophecy, He was basically saying, I said, God, California? Okay. I have other things to tell you too, a vision He gave me. Okay, so revival is coming to California, and I believe it might hit sooner than anywhere else. Although other places are already in revival, but this is going to be on mass proportion, and here's why. I said, God, why? You know, everybody expects it to drop off into the ocean. Why is California going to have revival? Why is it waves of glory in California? And He said, because I do hard things. And I was just, whoa, in the glory. And He said, I do hard things. And He said, California is hard. There's been so much deep-seated evil built up there that I have to call my people out to another level of warfare and fighting and awakening. And He said, the harder it is, the harder the devil falls. And He said, what it is that I'm calling my California people out, and I'm calling those who don't live in California to back California and pray for them and join arms and link Synergy of the Ages to California on behalf of the body of Christ that has been fighting for California for years and years and years. They have not run. They have not left because they want to see California saved. There's many ministries there that I love dearly. I know the pastors personally. And man, it's a fight in California. It's a job, serious job in California, to be an on-fire, spirit-filled pastor or evangelist in California. Because the devil fights even harder. And God said, I do hard things. And He said, California is one of the last places besides New York that people think of, man, California, they're done. They're just going to hell. There's no hope for them. And God's like, no, that is why there's hope for them. Because the devil has tried everything to build up his kingdom to be birthed, and evil fruit has come. And He said, California has been mostly known for its evil deeds. But He said, I'm going to be getting ready to make it known for being the forerunner. This is His words of the light of Christ. And He said, it's because I do hard things. I do hard things. I do hard things. And He said, the more work it takes, the more glorious of a victory. The more the church has to wake up, the more that the California Christians have to step into the glory and be willing to go with it and arise. He said, this is what I'm doing. I'm awakening that part of the body of Christ. And He said, because this is what's happened. He said, the Christians, the spirit-filled especially, in California, there is a portion of them that have gotten tired and weary. They just want to leave California. They just want to run away. They're like, man, they're going to hell. They're going to fall off into the ocean. Man, we just need to get out of here so that we can, quote unquote, go have an easier Christian walk somewhere else. And God is saying, no, body of Christ in California. No. You need to stay there and fight. And He said, this part of the body of Christ that has gotten to a place of not really complacency, but feeling like there's really no hope for California. God wants to raise you above that level of thinking to a place of being seated with Him in the heavenlies and fighting from a place of heaven so that heaven's agenda can prevail in California, because it shall prevail. Man, we broke through some demonic strongholds this weekend, and we fought through it. We had a glorious time. I had everyone come up on the second day of the summit, and I said, if you are here and you are not baptized in the Holy Spirit, you're going to need to be for this fight. And so I had people come up. They were baptized in the Holy Spirit. I laid hands on almost everybody there and those who needed fresh fire for the fight. It was a glorious time. People laying all over the grass in the glory. And I will tell you this, God wants to move and is going to move in California. And He needs the body of Christ in California to not see it as too hard, because God says nothing's too hard for me. And I will win California. I am already winning California. I am already, people may not see it or know it, but I am already winning California. In the spiritual realm, I am winning. And He said, there are oceans and oceans of glory available to the Christians in California. They just need to be willing to not step back, not believe that it's too hard, that California is too hard, that the evil is too deep-seated, it's too sick, it's too disgusting, that God can't uproot it. Yes, He can. But He needs the millions of Christians in California to rise up. And as I released this word over California at the prayer summit, I said there were only 12 disciples. 12. And they rocked the world. So California, you can do it. You can do it. And He gave me that verse, and the verses in Psalms 29. And I didn't really talk about these verses because I was ready to pray on some people and lay hands on some people and release some glory. But the God of glory thunders. The God of glory thunders in California. There is oceans of glory available to you, body of Christ in California. And I'm here to tell you, and I want everyone on this feed, if you're not from California, I want you to comment and I want you to give some encouragement that you are going to back California in praying for them for strength for the body of Christ in California. That as they rise up, that state shall be saved. California shall be saved. And it's much bigger than that. So listen to this. Then God gave me a vision, a glorious vision. And I'll just tell you, I said to Him, really? Okay, because you know, that's how I roll. So He gave me this vision. And in the vision, I was looking at the map of the United States. And I was an observer. And I was watching from this side, the West Coast. And I was standing like in the ocean facing California, the West Coast, and all of a sudden the water came up over and it spread out across the entire, I can feel the glory, spread out over the entire United States. And the entire United States was covered in the glory of God, in the water of the Holy Spirit. And then I had a vision of Jesus standing in the middle of the United States. And He took His hands and He leaned down and He was swirling His hands in the water. And He was playing in the water as though like a child plays in the water. As He was saying, I am pleased with this. And that He was in it, that He's in the thunder, He's in the water, He's in the fight, He's in it, church. And literally I said to God, okay, this vision is like saying revival's coming out of California. Like, it's coming up on the banks, and it's going to flood from the West Coast to the East. And I said, but it's the West Coast. Okay. I did do that, you guys. I am guilty. I was like, it's California. And the Lord was like, no. I do hard things. Revival shall come from California. That the glory waves, there's plenty of glory waves, and as they come up over the banks, it's going to flood California. And then that flood, those spirit-filled, especially Christians, the Christians that are fighting their rears off in California and believing that that state shall be saved. He said, as they walk in the glory and they become stronger and stronger and stronger, their presence is gonna be so invasive and invading in California, that's gonna be the forefront of the light of Christ. And He said, and as the glory comes over the banks, it's gonna shoot out past California and it's gonna spread out over the whole United States and it's gonna come from the East Coast, you guys. It's gonna come from California. But he said, I need my people in California to step into the glory. I need them to rise to the occasion and be willing to fight for the state of California, to be willing to see that I do hard things and there's nothing too hard for me. I will uproot the deep-seated, sick evil in California. It will be uprooted, and that state is going to be known for being a forerunner. And they're going to, you're going to be in the forefront of the light of Christ being shined on this whole nation. I am not joking, you guys. This is literally what he said. And in that vision, the glory was coming from California. It was coming from California. And it covered the entire United States. And it was a beautiful, beautiful thing. It was covered in the glory of God, the water of the Holy Spirit. And Jesus was just standing there playing in it, swirling his hands around in the water. And so I'm here to tell you, the God of glory thunders, and he's thundering over California. Hang tight, California. God may someday call you out of there. I don't know. But at this moment, he was so real with me. He is asking the Christians in California to stop joining in the complacency and the faithlessness of there's no hope for California. Stop that thinking and say no. God does hard things. He's a miracle-working God. And I declare that California shall be saved. Heaven's agenda shall prevail in California. And those that have been fighting for California and not walked away and given up on that state, you need to join their fight. Wherever their churches are, I can tell you where some of the churches are. You need to join their fight for California. I can name three churches: Bethel, Fearless LA, and the House Modesto. Join a church that's in revival and go with the glory, people of God. Go with the glory. And I'm sure there's many other great ministries out there, but those are ones that I know. No. And so here's the thing. California shall be saved. Amen. Amen. Go to Spirit Move. I'm going to pray for California in just a minute. Go to spiritmove.store. We have new shirts. I can feel the glory. Now we have a new one. Truth shall prevail. And we're just going to rock it, you guys. We're going to declare the message that is in this seasons right now. Go to Adventures in the Spirit and listen to my interview that I had on there. Also, my channel, Charisma Channel, will be being launched pretty soon. I'm hoping to get it organized enough to have it done by Easter or little after Easter, so be watching for that. Also, the Dreams class, you can buy it anytime you want. There's no limitation. The first session and course guide will be sent out by email to all those who buy the course on April 6th, so be watching for the first session. And then after that, you will get them on a weekly basis. The fifth one is a live Zoom call with me. I will be praying for you and activating dreams and visions in your life and declaring that over you, but it will be a live Zoom call, okay? And you will get the dates on that. I will be doing them every now and then because I know we're going to be having people buying the curriculum, so many people a week. And so you're not going to get left out. There's no timeline. You can do the curriculum whenever you want and get, you know, jump in on any of the Zoom calls. We'll get those out to those who buy the class. We'll get you a schedule of when those are going to happen. Anyway, let's pray for California. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we just lift up California. And we declare oceans of glory reside in California. We declare that you do hard things. We declare that all the evil, the deep-seated evil, will be uprooted in California. And that your will be done. We declare, Lord, over California that revival is coming out of California. And that revival is going to spread across the United States. They are going to be forerunners for the light of Christ. And we declare that right now And we declare your protection over the body of Christ in California as they rise up and fight for your glory and your kingdom and for heaven's agenda to prevail in California. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. You guys are awesome. Have an amazing day, and I will see you later. Man, I've got so many words brewing. I'll be on with you soon. Bye.